This is CBS 5 Eyewitness News.
Good evening, I'm Dana King.
And I'm Ken Bastida. The light brown apple moth. The government claims that it's an emergency for all of us. The proposed solution, aerial spraying of the entire Bay Area. But CBS 5 investigative reporter Anna Werner has uncovered some troubling information that suggests the state's claims may not hold up. Anna?
Well, Ken, you don't see any moths floating around among the skyscrapers downtown here, but this is where that moth spraying will take place, here in San Francisco and all around the Bay Area. Why? The state's been telling residents for months it's an emergency. But is it really? That's what we and some residents wanted to know.
I was having really bad time breathing, really bad wheezing.
9-year-old Nora Alonghi-Aaron went to the emergency room for the first time ever last fall.
This was a serious asthma attack that I've never seen in this child before.
It happened after the state sprayed pesticides over Santa Cruz and Monterey counties, and she's not alone.
Lung congestion, difficulty breathing, and shortness of breath.
For Mike Lindberg, who collected other reports of health problems,
it felt a little bit like an experiment on our health, and frankly, it was unwelcomed.
Especially since that was just the beginning. The state now plans to spray most of the Bay Area, not just once, but as often as 3 times a month for 9 months out of the year for 5 years or more. The reason? The light brown apple moth. It's native to Australia.
But now it's here, and the worry? The state says that tiny moth could cause millions of dollars in crop damage. But just how safe is it to spray those chemicals over the 7 million people in the Bay Area?
It's been shown to be incredibly safe.
He's State Agriculture Secretary A.G. Kawamura, who says because the moth is so widespread, it must be attacked with a pheromone product from the air.
We just don't have the logistical ability to cover 700-plus square miles with a ground crew.
He says the emergency is so great, the state can't even afford to wait for an environmental impact report.
If we were to wait a year, even 6, 7, 8 months, we might lose that window. We stand an excellent chance to eradicate it if we act on it quickly.
But this man says
it won't work.
James Carey is a professor of entomology at UC Davis and an expert on invasion biology, how insects get into an area and spread.
Historically, there is no precedent for this at all. None. The data argue absolutely for the impossibility of this eradication.
Why?
This is a huge infestation. No matter how much they spray this pheromone, it's simply not going to eradicate this population. It's simply too widespread.
I just disagree. We as a group, those of us who believe, we just disagree with him.
And one of Secretary Kawamura's reasons for disagreeing with the professor?
He's not an entomologist.
Are you sure he's not an entomologist?
No, he's not.
Well, I don't know where he got this one. Are you serious? I'm not an entomologist. I've never heard that. I am an entomologist.
But what's more, Carey says this is not even an emergency because he believes the moths have been in California for a long time.
At least 30 years, maybe even 50 years.
And with no crop damage by the state's own admission. But Kawamura says the potential for damage outweighs what he calls the negligible health risks of spraying over cities.
Looking at the science, we're told by the agencies that nothing should happen.
Should happen.
Nothing should happen.
But you can't say it won't happen.
Well, you can't.
When I saw what kind of test information was available for the chemicals in that product, almost no testing where the testing was done by breathing it in.
Pesticide researcher Carolyn Cox points out there's been no long-term testing for health impacts from breathing the spray.
Since that's the main way that we'll be exposed to it when the spraying occurs, that's a huge, huge lack of information.
Not so, says Secretary Kawamura, who relies on the EPA's registration process.
We can only use registered products in our eradication.
Yet a quick read of the label for the product used in Monterey and Santa Cruz County shows it's not registered for general use by the U.S. EPA. Instead, it received an emergency exemption, which bypasses the normal federal and California EPA processes. In fact, read the label more closely, and it shows the spray can't even be used this way in any other states, only in California. And Carey says of the entire program,
it won't work. And so that you'll end up having conducted this program for several years, subjecting people to the spray, yet not achieving eradication, which was the whole point, and you're still left with the light brown apple moth in California.
And public officials aren't placated. The San Francisco Board of Supervisors took a vote today and came out against the plan. And tomorrow in Sacramento, there are several bills coming up for a hearing from several legislators who are upset about this plan. We'll let you know what happens tomorrow from Sacramento. And by the way, Ken, the comment from the Secretary Kawamura about Professor Carey not being an entomologist, his aides now say he was simply confused.
All right.
Back to you.
All right. Anna Werner, thank you for that.